Hello, and welcome to Bedtime Stories. My name is Frank Padour, and I'll be reading to you a Grimm Brothers fairy tale entitled Rumpelstiltskin. There was once a miller who was very poor, but he had a beautiful daughter, and a thought struck him that he could speak about her to the king and get some situation for her. So he obtained an audience and told the king that he had a daughter who could spin straw into gold. Then, said the king, that is a quality which pleases me well. If your daughter is, as you say, so very skillful, bring her to the castle tomorrow morning, and I will try what she can do. The miller next day took his daughter to the castle, and as soon as she arrived, the king led her into a chamber which was quite full of straw, and placing a spinning wheel before her, said, Now set to work at once, for if all this straw is not spun into gold before sunrise, you shall die. Then he locked the door himself and left her alone. The poor maiden sat there for some time looking at the straw in despair. She had never in her life been taught to spin, and she had not the least idea how to turn straw into gold. Every moment her fear became greater, and at last she began to weep bitterly. As evening came on, the door opened, and a little man entered who said, Good evening, your daughter of the miller. Why do you weep so sadly? Oh, she replied, I have all this straw to spin into gold, and I know not how to do it. What will you give me, said the little man, if I spin it for you? My neck ribbon, she said. The man took the ribbon, seated himself before the spinning wheel, and as the wheel went whirl, 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 3 times, the spool was full of gold. Then he fastened on more straw, and after 3 turns of the wheel, the spool was a 2nd time full. And so he went on all night, and before the morning dawned, the straw was all spun, and the spools full of gold. Then he left her. At sunrise, the king came to the chamber, but when he caught sight of the glittering gold, he was first astonished, and then full of joy. But his heart was greedy for gold, so he led the miller's daughter into another chamber full of straw, and much larger than the former, and ordered her, as she valued her life, to spin that into gold before sunrise next morning. The maiden, when left alone, could only weep, for she knew it was an impossible task. But in the evening, the same little man again appeared and said, What will you give me if I spin all this straw into gold? My ring from my finger, answered the maiden. The little man took the ring, set to work at the spinning wheel, and before morning the whole of the straw was spun into gold. The king gloated with delight over the glittering heap, but he was not yet satiated with gold, so he led the maiden into a still larger room full of straw and said, You must spin for me during 1 more night, and if all of this straw spun into gold by the morning, then you shall be my wife. Although she is a miller's daughter, thought the king, I could not find a richer wife in the whole world. No sooner was the maiden alone than a mannikin again appeared for the 3rd time and said, What will you give me if I spin the straw for you this time? I have nothing more that I can give, answered the maiden. Then promise me when you are queen to give me your 1st child, said the little man. Who knows if I shall ever be queen, thought the maiden, and she knew also that in her trouble there was no other help for her, so she promised what he wished. Immediately he set to work, and very soon spun all the straw into gold. In the morning, when the king came and found that what he had required was done, he ordered preparations to be made for a splendid wedding, and in a few days the miller's beautiful daughter became a queen. About a year after this, a beautiful little child was born to the queen, who never thought of her promise to the little man, till one night he stepped suddenly into her chamber and said, Now give me what you have promised. In great terror, the queen offered him all the treasures in the kingdom if he would leave her the child. But the little man said, No, something living I like better than all the treasures in the world. Then the queen began to mourn and weep so bitterly that the little man had compassion on her and said, I will give you 3 days, and if in that time you can find out my name, then you shall keep your child. After he was gone, the queen lay awake till morning, thinking over all the names she had ever heard of, and determined to send a messenger all over the country to inquire far and wide what names had been given to people formerly. The next night the little man came again, and she repeated all the names she could think of, Casper, Melchior, Balzar, and many others that she knew in every rank of society. But the little man said, "No, I have not one of these names." The next day she made every inquiry among the neighbors, and when the little man came at night for the second time, she mentioned most unearthly names, such as Brown Ribs, Dicky Calf, and Spindle Leg. But he answered always, "No, it is none of these." On the third day the messenger returned and related his adventures. He had not been able to find a single new name, but on his way home he crossed a high mountain and came to the borders of a wood, in which the foxes and the hares wished him good night. After this, he came to a tiny little house and saw before it a fire burning, and hopping around it, on one leg, was a ridiculous-looking little man who cried, "Today I brew, tomorrow I bake, next morning I shall the queen's child take. How glad I am that she does not dream that Rumpelstiltskin is my name." The messenger could not think what made the queen so overjoyed when she heard this name, but she rewarded him handsomely and dismissed him. On the third and last night, the little man appeared for the last time and said, "Now then, queen mother, what is my name?" "Well," she replied, "are you called Conrad?" "No." "Henry?" "Nope." "Then your name is Rumpelstiltskin." "The fairies must have told you that. The fairies must have told you that," screamed the little man, and in his rage struck the ground so fiercely with his right foot that it sunk in deeply into the earth, dragging his body after it. Then, in his fury, he laid hold of his left foot with both hands and tore himself completely in halves. That was a Grimm Brothers fairy tale entitled Rumpelstiltskin. Thank you for listening. Good night and sweet dreams.